Hello everyone, welcome. As mentioned in the two previous videos, the development teams behind Nintendo Switch emulation projects are continuously working. Just a few hours ago, a highly anticipated update was released. It is now possible to run the game Red Dead Redemption using Vulkan. However, this update has not yet reached the early access version at the time of recording, being available only in the mainline. This surprise caught many people off guard, as the update came with only a small mention in the changelog. But before we delve into the details of this update and other information about Red Dead Redemption, I want to remind you to leave a like on this video and follow the channel to stay informed about all the emulation world news. Let's now explore the new features brought by this update and also discuss other details about Red Dead Redemption.
This video is offered by the members and Patreons of the channel. Thank you for your support.
Finally, the long-awaited update has arrived for Yuzu. Yes, my friends, we can now play Red Dead Redemption using the Vulkan API on Yuzu. However, I want to mention up front that the performance doesn't surpass that of Ryujinx. Both emulators are pretty much on par, and after doing some research and detailed observations, I found out that the game is capped at 65 FPS by Rockstar. So, until we have a community mod that allows us to remove this FPS cap, the only option to play the game above 60 FPS is by using Xenia. Now, who exactly will benefit from the game running in Vulkan on Yuzu? Those who have an older computer, which often struggles when trying to run Ryujinx. Or even when they manage to run the emulator, they face issues with slowness. In summary, the performance is pretty much the same on both emulators, at least until a mod is released to disable the dynamically set FPS limit of 65 FPS. Another crucial point, which I've reported in my last two videos, is that even in the latest versions of Ryujinx, there are still issues with some objects, horses, and other animations. This problem hasn't been reported when using Yuzu. To determine which emulator performs better, I conducted a test at 4320p to push my hardware and the emulators to the extreme. As can be seen, Ryujinx consumes more resources, including GPU, RAM, VRAM, and even CPU usage, which aligns with what I mentioned earlier. At the end of the tests, I obtained the following results. Yuzu achieved an average of 53 FPS, with a minimum of 35 and a maximum of 65, along with 29 FPS at the low 1%. Ryujinx, on the other hand, also obtained an average of 53 FPS, with a minimum of 28 and a maximum of 65, reaching 24 FPS at the low 1%. In the tests, both emulators were running at the same resolution and with shaders already compiled for both. In the video description, I will provide screenshots with all the settings I used in both emulators. If you want Yuzu to deliver even better performance, you can configure the CPU options in the emulator as unsafe. These settings allow the game to perform better and reduce potential slowdowns. This was our video with the weekend's news in Nintendo Switch emulation. As I have more updates, I will share them with you. I hope the video has been informative and useful for everyone. Until next time.